Hey, welcome back. My name is Sushant Satish and I am your trainer for this Azure Data Fundamentals, which is DP900 certification examination course. In this lesson, we're going to explore concepts of non-relational data. On a high level, we're going to learn about how to explore the characteristics of non-relational data. You will learn about how to define types of non-relational data, and you would be able to understand how to describe NoSQL and the types of non-relational databases. So without wasting any more time, let's get into it. Relational databases are an excellent tool for storing and retrieving data that has a well-known structure, containing fields that you can define in advance. In some situations, you might not have the required knowledge of the structure of your data. This is a common scenario in systems that consume data from a wide variety of sources, such as data injection pipelines. In these scenarios, non-relational database can prove extremely useful. So let's understand what are the characteristics of non-relational data. You use database to model some aspect of the real world. Entities in the real world often have highly variable structures. For example, in an e-commerce database that stores information about customers, how many telephone numbers does a customer have? A customer might have a landline and a mobile number, but some customers might have a business number, an additional home number, and maybe several mobile numbers. Similarly, the address of customer might not always follow the same format. Addresses of customers in different states and regions might contain different elements such as zip code or postal codes. In another scenario, you are ingesting data rapidly and you want to capture the data and save it very quickly. Processing the data and manipulating it into a set of rows in different tables in a relational database might not be appropriate at this point. You can perform these tasks as part at a later date. At the time of ingestion, you simply need to store the data in its original state and format. So a key aspect of non-relational database is that they enable you to store data in a very flexible manner. So non-relational database don't impose a schema on a data. Instead, they focus on the data itself rather than how to structure it. This approach means that you can store information in a natural format that mirrors the way in which you would consume, query, and use it. In a non-relational system, you store the information for entities in collections or containers rather than relational tables. Two entities in the same collection can have a different set of fields rather than a regular set of columns found in a relational table. The lack of fixed schema means that each entity must be self-describing. In this example, I mentioned about a non-relational collection of customer entities, so it looks like this. So the fields are prefixed with a name, and fields might also have multiple subfields, and also with names. In this example, multiple subfields are denoted by enclosing them in a square bracket. More advanced non-relational systems support indexing in a similar manner to an index in a relational database. Queries can then use the index to identify and fetch data based on non-key fields. Non-relational systems such as Azure Cosmos DB support indexing even when the structure of the index data can vary from record to record. So when you design a non-relational database, it's important to understand the capabilities of the database management system and type of query it will have to support. And please note that non-relational databases often provide their own proprietary language for managing and querying data. This language may be procedural or it may be similar to SQL. It depends on how the database is implemented by the database management system. So let's identify some of the non-relational database use cases. The first use case is IoT and telemetrics. These systems typically ingest large amounts of data in frequent bursts of activity. Non-relational database can store this information very quickly, and the data can then be used by analytics services such as Azure Machine Learning, Azure HD Insight, and Microsoft Power BI. Additionally, you can process the data in real time using Azure Functions, and that are triggered as data arrives in the database. The second scenario is retail and marketing. Microsoft uses Cosmos DB for its own e-commerce platforms that run as part of Windows Store and Xbox Live. It is also used in the retail industry for storing catalog data and for event sourcing in order processing pipelines. The next use case scenario is for gaming. So the database tier is a crucial component of gaming applications. Modern games perform graphical processing on mobile or console clients, but rely on the cloud to deliver customized and personalized content like in-game stats, social media integration, and high score leaderboards. Games often require single millisecond latencies for read and write to provide an engaging in-game experience. A game database needs to be fast and able to handle massive spike in request rate during new game launches and feature updates. Let's look at one more use case scenario. This time it is for web and mobile applications. A non-relational database such as Azure Cosmos DB is commonly used within web and mobile applications and is well suited for modeling social interactions, integrating with third-party services, and for building rich personalized experiences. So the Cosmos DB SDK can be used to build rich iOS and Android applications using the popular Xamarin framework. So this non-relational data generally fits into two categories, semi-structured and non-structured. So what is semi-structured data? Semi-structured data is the data that contains fields. The fields don't have to be the same in every entity. You only define the fields that you need on a per entity basis. One of the common ways of doing this is to store the data for each entity as a JSON document. The term JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It's the format used by JavaScript application to store data in memory, but can also be used to read and write documents to and from files as well. Let's look at the other format. Avro is a row-based format. It was created by Apache. Each record contains a header that describes the structure of the data in the record. This header is stored as JSON. The data is stored as binary information. An application uses the information in the header to parse the binary data and extract the fields it contains. Avro is a very good format for compressing data and minimizing storage and network bandwidth requirements. The next format is ORC, which is optimized row columnar format. ORC organizes data into columns rather than rows. It was developed by Hortonworks for optimizing read and write operations in Apache Hive. Hive is a data warehousing system that supports fast data summarization and querying over very large data sets. Hive supports SQL-like queries over unstructured data. And the next format is Parquet. Parquet is another columnar data format. It was created by Cloudera and Twitter. A Parquet file contains row groups. Data for each column is stored together in the same row group. Each row group contains one or more chunks of data. So let's understand what is unstructured data. Unstructured data is the data that doesn't naturally contain fields. Examples include video, audio, and other media streams. Each item is an amorphous blob of binary data. You can't search for specific elements in this data. You might choose to store data such as this in storage that is specifically designed for this purpose. In Azure, you would probably store video and audio data as block blobs in an Azure storage account. A block blob only supports basic read and write operations and has no internal search capability. You could also consider files as a form of unstructured data. although in some cases, file might include metadata that indicates what type of file it is. Is it a photograph, Word document, Excel spreadsheet, and so on? You could also consider files as a form of unstructured data. Although in some cases, file might include metadata that indicate what type of file it is, like photograph, Word document, Excel spreadsheet, and so on. However, the main content of the file is unstructured. So let's understand what is NoSQL. You might see the term NoSQL when reading about non-relational databases. NoSQL is a rather loose term that simply means non-relational. Some non-relational databases support a version of SQL adapted for documents rather than tables. NoSQL databases generally fall into four categories: key value stores, document databases, column family databases, and graph databases. So what is key value store? A key value store is the simplest type of NoSQL database for inserting and querying data. Each data item in a key value store has two elements, a key and a value. A key uniquely identifies the item and the value holds the data for the item. The value is opaque to the database management system and items are stored in key order. Let's understand what is a document database. A document database represents the opposite end of the NoSQL spectrum from a key value store. In a document database, each document has a unique ID, but the fields in the documents are transparent to the database management system. Document databases typically store data in JSON format, or they could be encoded using other formats such as XML, YAML, JSON, or BASON. Documents could even be stored as plain text. The field in documents are exposed to the storage management system, enabling an application to query and filter data by using the values in these fields. So what is a column family database? A column family database organizes data into rows and columns. Examples of this structure include ORC and Parquet files. In its simplest form, a column family database can appear very similar to a relational database, at least conceptually. The real power of a column family database lies in its denormalized approach to structuring sparse data. And the last one is graph databases. Graph databases enable you to store entities, but the main focus is on relationships that these entities have with each other. A graph database stores two types of information: nodes that you can think of as instances of entities, and edges, which specify the relationship between nodes. Nodes and edges can both have properties that provide information about that node or edge. Additionally, edges can have a direction indicating the nature of the relationship. The purpose of the graph database is to enable an application to effectively perform queries that traverse the network of nodes and edges and to analyze the relationship between entities. Let's look at this image for an example. This shows an organization's personal database structured as a graph. The entities are the employees, and the departments in the organization, and the edges indicate reporting lines and department in which employees work. In this graph, the arrows on the edges show the direction of the relationship. A structure such as this makes it straightforward to conduct inquiries such as find all employees who directly or indirectly work for Sarah, or who works in the same department as John. Azure Cosmos DB supports graph databases using Gremlin API. The Gremlin API is a standard language for creating and querying graphs. So that concludes this lesson. In the next video, we're going to explore concepts of data analytics. So I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care.